Hi everyone, my name is Vaishnavi, and in today's news, the Sensex has crossed the 40,000 mark for the first time ever, while Nifty 2 has breached the 12,000 level for the first time. The S&P BSE Sensex was first compiled in 1986 and is calculated on a market capitalization weighted methodology of 30 component stocks representing large and well-established financially sound companies across key sectors. The base year of the S&P BSE Sensex was taken as 1978-79. The S&P BSE Sensex today is widely reported in both domestic and international media markets through print as well as in electronic media. It is scientifically designed and is based on globally accepted construction and a review methodology. Coming to present news, the S&P BSE Sensex crossed the 40,000 mark for the first time today on May 23rd. The Sensex opened at a record of 39,591.77 and gained 1,014.75 points in the first half of the session to hit a fresh all-time high of 40,124.96. The Nifty was up by 2.51%, also touching an all-time high of 12,032.50. So why has the Sensex reached an all-time high? Well, one of the reasons for the Nifty and the Sensex all-time high can be related to the Lok Sabha elections. Experts had predicted a sharp upward movement if the new government was NDA-led. In the morning, many exit polls showed that the Prime Minister Narendra Modi returned, which has now become a reality. The NDA has won more than 300 seats out of 543, and the Congress is ahead in over 100 seats. The general elections are always a big event for capital markets because it defines the next 5 years and what kind of economic policies will be set in place. The NDA coming back for a second term will mean a stable government at the center with a strong leader and continuation of policies as well. Now also to consider the foreign institutional investments. Foreign institutional investors have been anticipating an NDA government-led. After the Balakot strike, foreign institutional investors were pumping in money since there was no cue that possibly that the BJP government and NDA alliance will be coming back. Because of the exit polls, it has been said that they are coming back. And as a result, the fear of uncertainty has gone and there is an assurance of political and policy stability. And now the fear has gone, which resulted in new money coming in from foreign investors. Foreign institutional investors have pulled out nearly rupees 10,000 crores in May during the uncertainty time. And with the certainty of the NDA government, they have put in rupees 1,700 crores on the exit polls forecasts. $10.41 a dollar, up from its previous close of 69.67. The Indian currency also opened at 69.50 a dollar. The currency has gained an 8 in out of the 10 in the total trading sessions. Oil prices also dropped, which extending falls from the previous sessions amid surging US crude inventories and weak demand from refineries. Brent crude futures, the international benchmark for oil prices, were also at a $70.62 per barrel, down 0.5% from their last close. So who were the best performers? The banking shares were among the top performers on the BSE earlier in the day. The S&P and BSE banking index hit an all-time high of 35,671, led by gains in the Bank of Baroda, Indus Ind Bank, Yes Bank, State Bank of India and Federal Bank. Rusmik Oza of Kotak Securities said that based on the readings of the BJP manifesto and the interim budget capital goods, construction, building materials, corporate banks, power equipment, housing financing companies could benefit the most in the next 1 year as opposed to consumption stocks. There is more value and upside in the mid and small cap space heroin. With NDA coming back into the power, which can expect local investors to take comfort in the mid and small cap space with a longer 2 to 3 year horizon and inflows could resume in them. The top Sensex gainers in the morning trade included Indus Ind Bank, SBI, L&T, Power Grid, Yes Bank, Kotak Bank, ICICI Bank, RIL, HDFC, Bharati Airtel and Axis Bank rallying up to 7%. While Vedanta, ONGC, Bajaj Auto and Sun Pharma slipped up to 1.92%. Elsewhere in Asia, China, Japan and Korea were trading on a negative note in their respective early sessions. Brent crude, the global benchmark, was trading at 70.58% per barrel, lower by 0.58%. That's all for the news with regards to why the Sensex is at an all-time high.